Building APIs in Python has become very easy nowadays, all thanks to FastAPI. So FastAPI is a high-performance Python framework for building a web-based APIs. In this tutorial, I'll teach you how to use FastAPI framework to build a machine learning-based API. So if you are looking forward to learn how to build APIs using the Python programming language FastAPI, this video is for you. Let's get right into it and learn how to build API. Okay guys, so we'll be building this API for the model we've trained in our previous tutorial. So in the previous tutorial, I taught you how to build your own classification model using Autrality's YOLO V8. Right here on my GitHub repository, I have that same model here. So the model name is the best.vt, and the link will be in the description where you can download this model and practice with. The link of the previous tutorial will also be in the description in case you want to learn how to build your own classification model using Autrality's YOLO V8. You can watch it and also be on the same page as we go. So I have the same folder on my desktop. So this is the folder we've used for that particular tutorial. And I'll just drag and drop this folder and open it with Visual Studio Code. Then we'll continue from there. So right here in my Visual Studio Code, you can see I've opened that same folder here, YOLO classification. And inside it, we have the scripts we've used in the previous tutorial. So I'll create a new script here and I'll name this script api.py. And what we'll do next is to download some additional packages we'll need. The first library we'll have to install is FastAPI. We'll also install UVCon and we'll install Python Multipath as well. We've already installed Autrality's, and installing Autrality's will install all other packages you need for you, such as NumPy, OPCV, Python, and the Pillow library and other related libraries. And I've already installed Autrality's in the previous tutorial. So here I'll just write pip install, and here we'll install FastAPI. We'll also install UVCon, and then finally we'll install Python-Multipath. I click enter and this will go ahead and install them for me. My requirement is already satisfied because I've installed all these libraries beforehand. Okay, so we'll go ahead now and import our packages. Alrighty guys, so these are the libraries we need to import. So I'm importing image from the Pillow library, and we'll be using this to read in our image file, the same as the IO. We use it to read the image alongside the Pillow library as well. And then from FastAPI, we are importing FastAPI, and we are also importing upload file, which we'll use it to validate our image we'll be using. Okay, so fast forward, I'll define a function here. This function has to load our model, so I'll call this function load model. The path is in one of the previous this one, so we just copy it in the test file. So okay, this is the model path, so I'll copy the complete model path here, and then in the api.py I can just replace this line of code with that, and our model right here is equal to YOLO, and then we give in the model path. So all this function will do is to return the model, and that's it. Alrighty guys, so we went ahead to define our function, and then this function takes in our model paths, and then we load the model using the YOLO instance right here, and we return the model. So to use this model, we can just say our model is equal to load model, and that's it. Okay, so now we've loaded our model successfully. The next thing to do is to create our FastAPI instance. So for that, we say app is equal to our FastAPI. I'll close the terminal, and right here we'll do our get request. So at app.get, and this request route will be like get predictions, because we are going to give predictions on our images. So we call it get predictions, and for every route you create, you need to create a function for it. So we'll say async, And then we create our function, and this function will also be called getPredictions, and that's it. So inside this function, we pass in our image file, and we use the upload file we've imported to do some validation. Okay, so the next step is to read in this image. So we can say our image here is equal to our file.read, but we can also use await here, make sure we can be doing other stuff whilst we are reading this image. So our image here is equal to await file.read. So that's how we read in this image whenever the user passes this image through our API. So now the next step is to change the format of our image before we can pass it into our model. Normally, PyTorch models accept images in pillow format or NumPy format. So we have to go ahead and do that. So we can still say our image is equal to image.open. And inside here, we can use the io.bytes.io. Then you can pass in your image. So the image will now automatically be converted to a pillow image. And over here, you can now send this image into your model to get some prediction. So you can see our result here is equal to our model. And right here, we can send it our image. And that's it. So this model takes in the image and it will return some predictions, and these predictions are saved in our result variable. The next thing we care about is the names. So to get the names that were predicted, or to get the names of our input model, so we can say our names is equal to result at the first index dot names, and this will return the names as to cats or dogs. So if you watch the previous tutorial, I've explained this and we've done this some couple of times. The next thing we also need is the probability or the confidence. So our probability is also equal to results. The first index dot props, and these props will be a PyTorch tensor. So we need to convert it into NumPy. So dot data dot NumPy. And this is what we are using the NumPy we've imported to do. So you convert our probability, which will be a PyTorch tensor, into a NumPy array so that we can work with it efficiently. Not forgetting my parentheses. Okay, so now we've gotten our names and we've gotten our probability. So this probability is going to be a NumPy array that is going to give you two values. One value representing the class of cats or the class of dogs. So if cat is detected, the probability for cats will be higher than that of dog. If dog is detected, vice versa. So what we will do is to pass this into the argmath function so that it always returns us only the class detected, the one detected with the highest probability. So we can still see our prediction right here is equal to np.argmath, and in the argmath function we are sending it our probability. Okay, so now we'll get our predictions, and this will be 1 or 0. So whenever we've predicted 0, we know it's a cat. And when we predict 1, we know it's a dog. So in a previous tutorial, we know that by just getting the names, these names returns you a dictionary where 0 means cat and 1 means dog. So we can now generate a response via our API. We'll call this response, and this will be equal to a dictionary where our key can, one of our keys will be prediction, and the value here is going to be our names in the key of prediction. Then we can have another key which we'll call the confidence, and this is also going to be the float value of our probability at the index of our prediction. And that's it. So this is the response our API will be returning to us. The final thing we can do here is to return this response. Okay, so anyone who makes a request to this API will just take in the image, pass this image through the model, get the names. So these names will be a dictionary where 0 represents cats and 1 represents dog. Then it gets the probability. We send this probability to the argmath function to return the highest probability. So if the highest probability is at index 0, it will return 0. If it's at index 1, it will return 1. So when it returns 0, it means we've predicted a cat. When it returns 1, that means we've predicted a dog. So finally, we've created a response here where we have a prediction as a key, and the response here is either cat or dog. We have our confidence and is the fluid value of our probability of our prediction. So this all we need to run this API, and what we'll do next is to run this code to see the outcome. So to run a fast API code, all you need to type is uvcon, then you write the name of your Python script. In our case, you have API, then you bring colon and you write app, then finally write hyphen hyphen reload and click enter. So you can see this is running right on this port for us. You can click on it and then we have detail not found. So all we do right here is to write /docs and click enter, and this will open up your API for you. So you can see we have a get request API endpoint here, and we can click on it and click on try it out, and then we can see how it works. So over here you can choose your image. I have some images here of dogs and cats. These are the same images we've used to test our model in the previous tutorial. So I'll click on this nice looking dog here and click on execute. So we got the response here is we are getting type error, fail to execute fetch on Windows. So that means we are having some errors which we need to fix. Okay guys, so right here this should be a post request and not a get request. So we are posting something, we are giving it some information. We are not just getting information, so we are giving it information. So get request is like you make a request where you are getting some information, but this thing we are sending in some information which is an image, though we are also getting some information though, but that would be our response. So this should be a post request. I don't know why I've used a get request, so I think that's the error. You click Control plus S and this will reload automatically. So anytime you just click on it, it should reload. Okay, we have gotten some keyboard interruption here, so I will just rerun the whole process once again. So I can get rid of the first one, and then here just go to /your docs, and then this will bring out our post API endpoint. So I'll click on it and click on try it. Now I'll upload the image. So let's use the nice looking dog once again and then click on execute. So you can see this is loading. I think it's passing through the model. So our status code is 200. That means it's working. And over here you can see the prediction is dog and the confidence is 0.95, almost 96% accurate that that is a dog. So we can try another image. I love this cat that looks like a tiger also, and I'll click on execute and let's see. Okay, so it's 99% sure that this is a cat. So the model works accurate and the API is also working great. And when I send you back to terminal, you can see we are getting status code of what, 200. Okay, that means everything is working great. So guys, this is how simple you can build API for this. And in upcoming tutorials, I'll teach you how to host this API so that the general public can just use it, or you can use it for your own use case. So yes, upload the image, you execute, and then it gives you a prediction. So right here, this is a dog and everything works as well. Let me know if you are interested in us hosting this API so that you can consume it for your own personal use. So it can be a mod, any other model you are designing this API for, but in this case we are just using cats and dog model. So guys, this is the end of the tutorial. If you love this tutorial, just drop some comments and click the like button. You can share this with one or two people, and I'll meet you in the upcoming tutorial. Thanks for watching.